Have you ever wondered why whiskey is not refrigerated? The simple answer is that it doesn't need to be kept in a refrigerator. In this video, we look at the reasons why and also some of the various storage methods that can help keep whiskey at its best. Before watching the video, consider subscribing to my channel and clicking the bell icon to be notified whenever I publish a new video. If you are already a subscriber, thank you for your support. You can keep your whiskey in the fridge or the freezer, but it will not freeze because at minimum 40% ABV or 80 proof, the alcohol content is too high for your consumer grade freezer to freeze it. So it won't harm the whiskey, it'll just make it cold. However, there are a couple of things to be aware of. Our tongues have not evolved to discern subtle nuances of flavor at extreme temperatures, hot or cold. So if you put your whiskey in the fridge or freezer, it will chill it so much that you can only taste about 60% of the whiskey itself. A similar thing happens if you put whiskey on ice as well. However, when you put whiskey on ice, it, in addition to chilling it so much that you don't really taste the whiskey at that temperature, it's also massively diluting it, even more so than if you were to add water to the whiskey. Furthermore, whiskey doesn't spoil like soda, milk, juice or other beverages do, so there's no need to chill whiskey in the first place. Whiskey's alcohol content is too high for bacteria and fungus to grow in it, generally speaking, which is why an unopened bottle of whiskey doesn't expire and can be stored indefinitely. So really, there's no need to chill it in the first place. Well, there's really only one valid reason to store your whiskey in the fridge or freezer, and that's if you like your whiskey chilled, and that's what you prefer. Many of the people that are watching this video are most likely whiskey tribe members, whiskey enthusiasts, malt members, or just fancy themselves a connoisseur of whiskey. They probably like to try different things, they like to explore, they buy a bottle here and there, and over time, they amass a respectable collection of various types of whiskeys. So there's a need to explain how to care for your collection, and after you've opened a few bottles. The first rule is to store your bottles upright. There's a common misconception amongst non-whiskey drinkers that whiskey should be stored slanted to keep the cork wet, and thus, the seal on the whiskey intact. While this works with wine, it doesn't work with whiskey because of the high alcohol content. This works for wine and beer bottles that are corked, because we're dealing with a drink that's around 4-16% ABV. Whiskey, as you'll recall, is more than double that amount of alcoholic content at 40% ABV or 80 proof, minimum. With that high of an alcoholic content, the alcohol in the whiskey will just eat and destroy that cork, ruining the seal, and thus, achieving the exact opposite of what you want. So do the sensible thing and don't treat whiskey like wine. Treat it like whiskey and store the bottles upright. If you are concerned about keeping the cork moist, then all you need to do with whiskey is once in a while just tilt the bottle down then right back up quickly, and that's more than sufficient to keep a whiskey cork moist and keeping the seal nice and tight. Are you enjoying the video? Please give me a like and subscribe, let's keep going. The second rule is to store whiskey indoors at a stable temperature and in a cool dark place. It's a common misconception amongst non-whiskey drinkers that whiskey spoils like other drinks do, and thus, needs to be stored in a fridge or freezer. But, whiskey doesn't spoil like milk, juice, soda, or indeed, beer and wine do. While it won't harm the whiskey to store it in the fridge or freezer, it's not ideal for the whiskey either. The best place to store whiskey is indoors, and in a place in your home that's removed from direct sunlight, and stays at a relatively stable temperature. In other words, your pantry is more than sufficient for storing whiskey in, and it's perfectly fine to store whiskey at room temperature. It's actually preferred because neat pours of whiskey should be served at room temperature, or slightly below. Now, why do we want to store it away from the window or out of direct sunlight? Because not only will sunlight discolor the whiskey and fade the label, it will also affect the tannins in the whiskey, and thus, affecting the flavor, and that's a bad thing. So avoid the sun at all costs. As stated earlier, direct sunlight affects the tannins in whiskey, and thus, ruins the flavor. The next question is how to store already opened bottles of whiskey. Say you've opened your whiskey bottle and are worried about the flavor being affected. Not to worry, as the cork will be your friend here. As I said, one flip is more than sufficient to keep the cork moist. Now, what to do when only a third of the bottle is full of whiskey? When there's more oxygen than whiskey in the bottle, this can affect the flavor quite a bit, so it's best finished in about a month. So drink it. Don't rush though, you have about a few months before the flavor is affected by a tiny amount, So if there's more air than whiskey in the bottle, just finish that bottle up. If your whiskey came in a tin, and not a cardboard box, like, for example, Laphroaig or Glenfiddich, then you want to periodically check that the bottle isn't becoming too damp. Cardboard boxes breathe a little more, while the tins don't, so tin can trap in moisture, which is important if you live in a humid climate. So every once in a while, just check up on it. If it's getting too damp, just wipe down the bottle, and you're good. And that's it, really. Storing whiskey isn't as much of a pain in the neck as storing wine. If you have a kitchen pantry, or a similar place in your home, that's more than sufficient to store your whiskey. Just keep it out of direct sunlight, store the bottles upright, and keep them around room temperature. You have finally made it to the end of the video and I hope you learned a thing or two. Why not celebrate by clicking that subscribe button? See you next time.